Yeah, well, my story started like every other guy I know. My grandfather was a clone, dad was a clone, so I figured I'd just stick with the family business and join up with the Galactic Empire as well. So I went through basic back on Coruscant, just like everybody else. I wasn't a big overachiever, so I figured I was gonna get stuck on some backwater planet like Tatooine or something. But as luck would have it, I was stationed on the first Death Star. And it was going great. We had 3 square meals a day, a few clubs to relax in, and all that junk. Like I said, it was great. Well, at least until that old man and that stupid aluminum falcon showed up. Anyways, I didn't get to be in the hangar when the pirate scum came on board because I had drawn tractor beam generator duty that morning. It should have been a boring day, and I still say it was. I mean, I've looked at the video and I still don't see how that old guy did it. So, yeah. That was kind of a last straw for my commanding officer. I'd been late a few times for watch. My armor had some rust on it during some inspections. But I think the guy just didn't like me and he had it out for me and he used it as some kind of excuse to get rid of me. Anyways, I guess I came out of that deal okay. Well, I figured I was on the fast track to the basement and that my career was pretty much over. But as luck would have it, the shuttle they shipped me out on was the shuttle that ended up picking up Darth Vader. Do you know what a Sith Lord smells like after 3 days in a TIE fighter cockpit? That was the worst thing I've smelled since the time me and the guys had one too many at the cantina decided to have garbage chute races. Bad smell. Really bad. Lord Vader was so happy to be picked up, he promoted me to be one of his personal bodyguards. Hey, lucky me, right? I go from the basement to the top floor. Executive suites, catered meals, and all that. Boy, was I ever wrong. It seems his lordship is a bit of a hands-on type of guy. Next thing I know, somebody throws me a cold weather suit, and we're on our way to the lovely frozen tundra of Hoth. Man, that place was a waste of time. And it was so cold too. I nearly froze my babalones off. You know what I'm saying? Then Darth Vader, he decided to go looking for some stupid kid and I got reassigned. And wouldn't you know it, I get reassigned to the second Death Star. I mean, I'm one of the 2 people that survived the first one. Do you really think I want to be on the second one? Lucky for me, those rebels showed up again and destroyed that thing. I tell you, I was gonna take off myself if it weren't for them. But I barely made it out of that one. And well, that pretty much ended my career as being a stormtrooper. I wasn't really sure what I was gonna do next. I was part of an evil dictatorship that was taking over the galaxy with war and violence, trying to use fear tactics and trying to kill. I didn't think I'd be able to get a job, much less start a new career. Then I get an email notifying me that I haven't used my GI Bill. GI Bill? GI Bill? The Emperor was dead, the Empire was destroyed, but I could still use my GI Bill? Hey. I wasn't gonna question it. I used that puppy and got back to school. I had always been into drawing when I was a kid, so I figured I'd go to a place that would nurture the designer that was inside of me. So that's how I ended up here. I don't know where it's gonna lead, but I know it's better than where I was. Well, I gotta get to class, and I don't wanna be late for my first day. This guy Barretts is my teacher, and I don't wanna piss him off. You know, I feel like I've been given a second chance to do things better in my life and to do something for the world. And I hope, you know, I just hope that is what happens here. And, you know, it's all I can really do is to hold on to that and pray that I get through.